Hi, this is Booping the Tube. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I will show you how to fix the problem when you try to download an app on Amazon Kindle Fire. So if I now go to the App Store and try to download Spotify as an example, this applies to the other applications, and I get this error message saying there was an error while downloading Spotify Music. Please try again. So what's the solution to this? I try a lot of different things, and the only thing I can find to fix this problem is to go and reset my Kindle Fire. In order to do that, we need to go to the settings. So you go to settings, you go to device options. In the device option, you see a place called backup and restore. So you have two options here: to save Wi-Fi passwords to Amazon so that Amazon would remember your Wi-Fi password, so that it would automatically connect after it resetted its device, or when you buy a new device from Amazon, it would automatically remember, such as Amazon Echo. But I would strongly recommend you to back up your data, to back up all the information on your Kindle, such as files on this device, settings, network, bookmarks, install apps. So all you need to do is this, select here. Now it should back up everything. It might take some time for it. Please note that it says backup runs automatically once a week when the device is on standby and connected to Wi-Fi. So make sure your Wi-Fi is on, and this might take, as it says, at least 1 week for it to back up. So you might have to come back to the next step a week later. Unfortunately, there is nowhere that tells me how many backups it has and whether it already has backed up. So I suggest you to at least leave your device for 2 weeks to make sure everything is backed up. I also suggest you to sign in into different applications you got and make sure those applications are linked with an online account. Once you're sure everything you got is backed up, and if things after resetting the Kindle wouldn't come back, you still have them somewhere stored, such as your photos, music, pictures, anything. Please keep them safe, because the next step it's gonna do, it's gonna reset your Fire Kindle to the factory. So next step would be the factory reset, which would erase almost everything. So when you come back here to device options, you select reset to factory defaults. You can read the message here. It's self-explanatory. It would erase all your information, so be sure you got it back up. I can't emphasize enough on that. Then you just select reset. So to set up our Fire, we need to select the country, choose your language, English, United States. I'm okay with that. You can select the size of the text, touch continue. Now you need to select your Wi-Fi. After you touched connect, you need to register your Fire by entering your Amazon email ID or mobile number and Amazon password. Once you enter them, then touch continue. If you don't have, you have to create a new one and then touch continue. Now it's checking for the saved backups. So it's up to you to turn them on or off, but I let them to be on because some of the applications that they use, they require this location, they need Wi-Fi and other things to verify you as the person, such as downloading an app. But you can try it without it, but I will try with it. So then continue, gives you some tutorial. Somebody forces you to watch that video, but again, it wants to tell you that how useful Alexa can be, and I think it is useful. I got Amazon Echo, which I use it very regularly, almost every day. So on this device also, I would enable Alexa. You can create a child profile. I don't need that. Not now. Not, no thanks. Not now. Not now. So here it is, our Alexa has been resetted, and now we try to download an app and see whether now it can download Spotify or other apps and that it will work. So let's go to App Store, search, type in Spotify, it comes up here, touch get, touch download. So far so good, download is started. Wow, the installation is complete. So you click, you touch on open or get, login, and you know the rest. I mean, the purpose of this video was to show you how you could fix this problem when you try to download an app and you can't. And the solution I've shown you was by resetting your Kindle Fire. But remember, it's very important to backup everything, because you can't be sure that this would work the way you want it to work, that it will backup everything. And usually resetting your device helps sort this kind of problems, and it's not a bad idea to try to reset your device every now and then, every few years. Thanks for watching. If this video was useful, please don't forget to subscribe, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye bye.